Hi friends, this is Ranjit. Welcome back to our YouTube channel, Paradigm CAD Academy. If you haven't subscribed our channel, kindly subscribe it to see more amazing videos on CAD projects like this. So if you are interested in learning CAD softwares, CAE softwares, you can contact us on our contact number, that is 7506706016. So in today's part, we will be designing this badminton racket from the scratch. Okay, so this is our mini project for a students who knows basics about CATIA surface design. So let's start designing this first head part of badminton racket. So the part after completing in a CATIA will look like this one, and after application of the material, the final product will look like the image that I have shown in earlier. So the image will look like this one. Okay, so let's start designing the part. So I will go and create a new part. And I will go into start mechanical design, wireframe and surface design workbench. Okay, so the basic dimension for designing this part is available in. So we will be drawing this head part first. So for drawing that, we need to draw an ellipse of major diameter 300 and minor diameter of 200. And they have given the section AA at the center point, and the dimension of the section will be given. It has a RX 10 and RX RY 7. That means there will be an elliptical section which moves along this path of this ellipse 300 by 200. So I will just go into CATIA. I will select the top plane. So I will select this XY plane and I will draw the simple sketch of an ellipse. So for creating an ellipse, you can go into this sketches or a profile toolbar and select this ellipse type option, and I will specify the major radius as 150 and minor radius as 100, and I will specify angle to be 0. You can get an elliptical section. So we will be using a sweep command. So for using sweep command, we need to draw first path, and then we will draw a profile on this plane. So I will again go into sketcher tab. So I will draw an ellipse. So I will just see the orientation of that ellipse, and I will draw an ellipse at this location. So again, my major radius will be 7 and my minor radius will be 10 and my angle will be 0. Okay, and this should intersect to this line. So I will just make a dimension between the center point and the origin, and this dimension they have given it as 100, and I will press the exit workbench. Then we will be sweeping this circle along this profile. So for that we will be using this sweep option, and in sweep we will be using sweep along a single guide option. So I will use this with reference surface. I will use profile as this surface, and for a guide curve I will select this one and I will press OK. So now you can observe that the head of this badminton racket is completed. Then I will just hide the reference sketches. Then the next part we will be drawing is a part which connect this head with the handle. So this will be this part. Okay, and for drawing that part, they have given this arc as 200, center to center end to end distance will be 110, then center to first point distance is 125, and center to end point distance will be 275. So I will again use sweep along guide option, that is sweep with the help of reference surface. So I will again go into this top plane and I will draw a sketch. So in this I will draw firstly a straight line and then I will draw an arc. And I will make sure that this arc is tangent to this line. And then we will be defining distance of this point from this as a 55. Then the distance of this origin to this point, they have mentioned it as a 125. Distance of this line from this location is they have given it as a 225. And I will just make sure that the distance between the two points, like this point and this, they have mentioned, and they have mentioned the radius. So the radius will be 200. Okay, so I will go and check the dimensions. So this distance is 275, and the distance between the end point, they have mentioned it as a section BB. So I will go into this section and you can see that it will be totally 30. So from the center point, it will be located at a distance of 15 mm. So I will change this to 275 and I will change this to 15 mm. Sorry. This one I will change this to 15 mm and I will press exit. Again, the same procedure. We now need to draw a profile. So for that I will create a plane. This plane should be normal to this profile and I will go into the sketcher option and I will select this plane. And again the dimensions will be same, so I will just see the orientation of that part and I will make a reverse orientation and I will draw an ellipse at this location. So again they have mentioned the dimensions, like total dimension is 10 and end to end height will be 17.5. Okay, so I will just end to end distance, they have mentioned it as of 10, so it will be 5 and it will be 17.5 divided by 2 and the angle will be 0. So I think it will be 17.5 divided by 2. Okay. So this distance is 17.5 because they are specified in terms of diameter. And then we will be making this point coincident with the profile, sorry, with path. Okay, then the next part is to sweep this ellipse along the curvature. So I will again use the same option with reference. In profile, I will select this ellipse option and in guide, I will select this line. And I will press OK. Again, I will hide the two sketches. I will hide this plane. So I will show this plane right now. Afterwards, I will hide this plane. Then I will mirror this sweep. So for mirroring, I will use this symmetry option and I will make this symmetry about this line and press OK. Then I will make split. So my element to cut will be this one and the cutting element will be this one. Similarly, I will select the split. This is element to cut and cutting element will be this one. And I will press OK. Okay, then the next thing is draw section DD at a distance of 175. The section DD is again elliptical section. And we need to draw a section at a BB. And we will be connecting section BB and section DD with the help of multi-section surface because we do have two different cross sections. So I will again go and select the sketch on this plane I will select the normal to view option. I will make this ellipse and this ellipse projection, and I will draw a single line from this to this. And the distance of this line, they have given it as a 23.5. Similarly, I will just make this line mirror about this horizontal line, and I will trim the unnecessary portion. So I will trim this internal part of this line and I will message it. So the next step is to connect this section with the section which is located at a distance of 175 mm reverse direction, and I will select this plane again and I will make a sketch, and the sketch will be elliptical one again. So I will just press normal to view. I will draw an ellipse with a major radius of 20, minor radius of 22.5, and the angle will be 0. You can cross check that. This dimension they have given it as a 45, and this dimension they have given it as a 40. And I will press exit. Now we need to connect these two sections. So this section has a 4 points, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So we need to divide this section into 4 equal points. So I will just use a point and I will draw point at a random on this circle. And I will press exit. I will just zoom out the view. And we need to connect these two sections. So for connecting that, we will use this multi-section surface. I will select this sketch first, this sketch second, and in a closing point I will check that for a first section closing point it is at this location. So I will change the closing point location to this part. Then the next part is to specify the coupling. So I will specify it as a ratio and I will press OK. So it will connect the two sections. Again, you can hide the sketches. I will hide this sketch and I will hide this sketch. Okay. They have mentioned this dimension at 125 mm, and a section at this location, they have given it as a circular section of diameter 45. So I will draw one more plane in a reverse direction at a 125 mm distance, and I will draw a sketch at this plane. So I will just reverse the view and I will draw a circle at this location, and which is of diameter 45. And we will be connecting these two sections with the help of again multi-section surface. So this is my first section, first surface. So the direction will be this, in this direction, and my second section. Okay, so this is my first section, this is my second section. So we'll just reverse the direction now. And I will press ratio and I will press OK. Okay, so we don't need this support. So I will just remove this support. And the last part is to fill this section. So I will just select this and I will press OK. So this is how you can draw a badminton racket head and the part connecting the head and the handle and the handlebar. And if you want to hide all the planes at one time, then you can use this Control F shortcut key, go to part design, go to planes, and and select all option and just hide this option. So we'll just select this show and hide. So it will automatically hide. In the next part, that is part 2, we will be drawing the internal nets in this badminton head. Thank you, friends.